All right, you guys, we are here in the Bronx, New York, known by the one and only Fat Joe. Y'all know, lean back. But listen, yesterday's price is no longer today's price when it comes to the price of liberating education for our young people. We're here at Pharos Academy with the revolutionary leader himself, Dr. Travis Brown. Let's see what's up.
So when we talk about revolutionary,
shout to my OSG family. We continue on, unction the building live and direct. You know what I do on Thursday, Thursday. We are strong today. Shout out to Easy Breezy, Dennis Mckesey, the visionary extraordinaire himself. What's going on? Steady, are you ready? Are you ready? What's going on? What's going on? Cold fresh air, feel the melody that's in the air. I'm down, take a look around. What's going down? However, you want me.
The only way you walk through our building is if you're a crew member.
Okay.
All right? So we believe in crew life here. So the way you spend in the crew, you look up here. We want you, you have the crew of Dominium, which is self-direction and self-management. The crew of Caminante, which is community. You have Pensando, my crew. Crew of critical thinking. And you have Sadar with a crew of effective communication. So before you spin the wheel, you think of which one you want to get. The wheel is never wrong. You either pick the crew you want, or the wheel gives you the crew you need. So you're now part of Dominium. Yeah, crew of ownership and self-management. There we go.
You know what I'm saying? Like, how you doing?
This is our old to 80s train stations,
yeah,
right here.
Yeah.
And every word is a means light. So just the different, man. Yeah. And then when you're hungry, you can step up in here. Let me show you.
Oh, yo. How you guys doing?
Hi, how are you?
All right. So, yo, this is amazing.
Yeah, something like that.
We just really amazed with this facility. It's just amazing. I'm Principal Rahh. Nice meeting you. I'm Principal Rahh. Nice meeting you. Nice meeting you.
How are you?
How you doing? I'm Principal Rahh.
Hi, how are you?
Nice meeting you. Wow. Yo, this, yeah, this is crazy.
I'm on my school to school like this.
Yeah, yeah.
OSG Studios, everybody know OSG stands for off school grounds, but we in school, but we gonna show them how we get off school grounds and on school grounds.
Come on, man. Flex on them real quick.
Oh, we got the hidden
door. I missed it. Wait, wait.
We got the hidden door.
Come on in. Oh,
you got the hidden.
Can't beat it. Can't beat it, man. You want to just drop something real quick for Teach Jam. Yo, I love this, Trav, man. They got music studios in the school, state of the art, man. You can see the soundboards, you can see the speakers. You see, this is premium quality for premium students, man. It's inspiring, man. This is revolutionary.
Yeah, honestly, we haven't had a fight in about 8 years here, and this is a high school, a public urban high school.
Wait, hold on, did you guys hear that? You know, I brag about saying that the first 3 years of my school had zero fights. This man, the Dr. Travis Brown, you said 8 years?
8 years.
Listen, I'm a math teacher, I don't even know how many days that is, but if you do that times 8, that's a lot of days with no fights. How? Tell us how.
I think it's part of it is that revolutionary culture that you speak of, and also our model of K-12 education. We get our babies from kindergarten, and how we just groom them and work with them in their families. By the time they get to high school, they're a family. They take complete ownership of their space. So we don't have the problems with graffiti. They're more likely to be upset with us than each other. They learn how to solve and negotiate issues between each other. The bell, you know, we're in a school.
We are in a school building.
But yeah, over the last 8 years, no fights.
Wow, wow. Yo, y'all hear that? Listen, you build a family atmosphere that can really change your school culture. Man, we're excited to see more. Let's get it.
Let's do it.
You said, talking about revolutionary school culture, you letting the world see.
Yeah, we transform everything, man.
Next level.
Got to. Well, you know, since we got the nautical theme, gotta have the fish, right?
Yo.
It just feels like love and care to
attention
to detail.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even wasting an opportunity to make an impact.
Even when you talk about teachers and they gotta make bulletin boards and do that, we just need you to put up the student work. Nah, just put the student work up. We built the bulletin board.
That's so good.
I know you don't want to waste your time, like, you know. So we got the lighthouse, the waves. Yeah, you know, then the college representation. So, man, listen, they guys that do woodwork, and I say I need this, so we started building book trees also.
All right.
So, yeah.
Wow. You got the slide here. You got the books here. You got the.
We gotta get our babies to slide.
Everything here is 5-star. This is a 5-star school.
And this is the forest.
How much is it? You know what I mean? Right. Like, that's what it
is. This is a 5-star school.
And it's all free.
All free.
I had looked at when I'm buying one of these for my house. Oh,
yeah. You charge your phone right there.
Oh, you got the wireless? Yeah, why not, man?
I don't know if it's working right now, but it's supposed to work.
Okay.
Man. Your case might be in the way. I'm just saying.
You know? This is
not you.
So now you can. Yo, this is crazy.
Yeah, and if you want to have a private meeting, you close in. You got it.
This is different. This is different. How does this make you guys feel? Like when you see this, y'all know this is not like at other schools.
Yeah,
100%. Right? Like
it's definitely like, it's kind of a lot. I've just been here for 2 days, so it's kind of like, just
yeah.
Kind of getting used to it. It's nothing like
five. Yeah, no, this is amazing. Yo, listen, I was blown away by your school, man, but I gotta ask you this question. I've been asking leaders all across the country. What is revolutionary about your school?
It's a good question. What first comes to mind is everything. And I think the reason why I say everything is because our approach is we see a lot of schools and leaders try to fight the kid current. I go with the kid current. And what I mean by that is anything that children want to do, what they dream of, what they're interested in, we tap into that and we bring it to the school. So whether it's music production, I think in my head, how do I bring a studio to school?
Yeah.
Whether it's podcasting, how do I bring a podcast studio to school?
Yeah.
I heard about a young man who was cutting everybody's hair on a roof in a building in the Bronx. And I'm like, that's interesting. But he really wants to be a barber or has an inclination to cut hair. How do I not shun that? But how do I invest in that?
Yeah.
So we're bringing a barber program to the school.
That's great.
So yeah, but it's all about how do you think about what kids' interests are and how do you amplify those things? So I think revolutionary culture is about amplifying the things that kids already have in them. We try to bring the best resources, people, materials, so that honestly, so that we can really build on their interests and help them build bodies of work that makes sense in the future. Because one thing that's revolutionary about what we do is we want kids don't do work here. they build bodies of work. Mm. And that's different. They're not doing work. Yeah. They're not doing work. We want them to build bodies of work. And we want to make them really interesting people. So when we talk about revolutionary college campuses and the workplace and the future of work, they want interesting people that are curious, that are interested in things. And I think we need to redefine and be revolutionary around stop sitting kids in classes and just getting them to be passive in education. How do you inspire young people to build real things? We always talk about real world, authentic assessments.
Wow, wow. Now let me ask you this. We have leaders that, y'all heard this, like authentic, yeah, y'all heard earlier. I mean, zero fights in 8 years.
Yeah.
That's the what. How did you do it? Like how? I know you have a crew system, we've seen the will, the sense of belonging, all this love that exists, but how do you get your staff involved, the community involved? Like, what was that process?
I think it's how you talk to your babies. Mm. Like, when our kids come through the door, we're at the door, we're playing music, but more importantly, we're starting that conversation with them from day one. And we call it the Walmart model. Like, we don't say go to class here.
Right.
We shake their hand, say, how you doing? We make sure they tied.
Yeah.
Those touches and things like that, kids feel safe here. So we're in New York City, no metal detectors. New York City high school is a plague with metal detectors, no metal detectors. But guess what? You're gonna get touched a lot here. You're gonna get talked to a lot here. When you're out of class, we're gonna talk, I'm gonna take you to class, but I'm gonna talk to you. I'm gonna see what's going on in your life. And these things may sound simple, but simple is not trivial. It's about relationships, and it's around how are you building culture in your school? Like we were talking about earlier, people, it's not culture for culture's sake.
Yeah.
How do you build a culture of kindness in your school? Mm-hmm. How do you end, and you talk about the crew system. People want to do the crew system and get happy and things like that, but you have to go layers underneath.
Yeah.
The crew system is so kids won't bully each other, and you end social isolation. So in the elementary school, and this is revolutionary, and I think so, it's around, at lunch, we have lunch tables. So students don't sit where they want to at lunch. We assign eight kids to each lunch table for the entire month.
Wow.
So you don't have best friends here. Well, one best friend, you have a lot of best friends. So for that entire month, you have to get to know everybody at the table. You have to learn their names. You have to learn a lot of things about them. You have to play games with them. And then the next month, you change your group.
Yeah.
Because we're trying to end the othering of kids, social isolation. I can beat you up if I don't know you.
Mm-hmm.
I can kick your butt if I don't care about you.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. And I know as schools grow, it's harder, but that's why house systems, crew systems, as we call it, are super important. But it has to go past the colors, the parties, the things like that.
Yeah.
It has to get down to the actual fabric of what it's supposed to be, and that's really getting young people together to talk with each other and meet a lot of different people. So I see our motto here is no best friends, a lot of best friends. And I think that's super important.
Wow. Listen, y'all. We only scratching the surface, and you can tell this brother's a genius when it comes to the work around his school building and the work we're building a sense of belonging for young people. You know, one of our mantras is we want to make everybody feel like somebody. And I think you guys are doing a wonderful job here.
Appreciate
and
that.
And listen, we definitely going to be coming back because there's more. We didn't even get to everything because it was so much that this school offers their young babies and their school community.
Integrity.
But listen, thank you for having us.
Unified.
Thank you. Appreciate you, Dr. Brown.
OSG, change the game. Come together, bringing leaders, we don't play. Make a difference, being different, switching lanes. Live on purpose, get creative every day.